Chris. A-Hole Productions. Yeah, you were here, I think, that night where I played the first episode or the first chapter of Leon's. I think you popped in the chat and you were like, you'd like just to stop in and say, hey, after you got off work. And I was like, oh, don't worry. We're just having like a Resident Evil fan theory night. And like, I still want to play this with you. And I was like, it was nice to finally like save this game. Cause also yeah. Lil C, like I told him he and I would play the Chris Redfield campaign. I'm going to try to work it out with him for next weekend. What are you saying?
I close tomorrow on Saturday is normally like our busiest day. Uh-huh. So I'll probably get out of there at the latest. Since we close at 9:30, I'll say about 11. It'll be our latest.
Oh, wow. Really? 11. Dang.
There's been worse. It was like Black Friday. Yep, it was Black Friday. I didn't get out of there till like 3 o'clock in the morning.
Jeez, yeah, holiday hours, like for us at Lego, they get bad, but they're only bad in comparison to like not compared to that, obviously, like 11 or 3. Like the latest we've ever closed one night was 11, you know, like we were 10, I think, and we were out of there by 11. So, yeah, it was like, I don't know. I'm not used to those hours anymore. But I used to, like I used to work crazy hours like that. So I definitely don't envy you, but I'm glad, now that the holidays are done, do you go back to semi-normal hours?
Yeah. Like if I open working at the fitter room, I don't have to be at work till 10 instead of like 9.
Gotcha.
Cause like during Christmas, I worked at Christmas Eve. I worked from 6 in the morning till 4 o'clock.
Yeah. Gotcha. Blue thing up here.
Hey, what was up there? Oh, you see? It's showing me something I didn't even know was there.
Yeah, I always forget that one because usually you just run and grab this this lever. But I remember one time I was playing this and I go, before I grabbed the lever, I was like, this would be a perfect spot to put something because you never come back to this room. And normally in video games, they do that to you. You're like, oh, shit, it was in the room behind me. Gogeta says, the real question is, what do I name this human noble character? I have an idea. How about Kitty comes up with his first name and I come up with the character's last name?
I would name it after one of my favorite characters, which would be first name is Jimmy.
Jimmy?
Yes.
So, Jimmy Ketch. K-E-T-C-H. Jimmy Ketch. What do you think of that? Is that good enough for you? Ketch is the name of my favorite Ghost Rider. Dan Ketch was his name.
I like Jimmy Kudo. Whoa. From Case Closed.
Oh, gotcha.
Or you can use his alias, Conan.
Ooh, Conan. And you can use Ketch's alias, Kale. Conan Kale. Actually, don't do that. His last name is already assigned to him, Kuzland. So Jimmy Kuzland. All right, so there you go, Jimmy Kuzland. Nice, I'm glad we could help. Good job, Kitty. Nice. Jimmy Kuzland. All right. He sounds noble.
This part, I hate these blades. And you know, like in five, they could have jumped over this trap. They really could have. Oh, that's charming. Oh, that was story on my
part. What happened?
I got up by accident.
I thought I was going to do that too. I was like running right towards the blades and then I slid. And then I was like, all right, I'm done. I'm going to get my character's going to get right back up. But I guess holding the button helps. I was wondering, I was like, oh, does holding it save you or keep you safe?
Sometimes it do, and sometimes she just stands there. She just stays there. at roll. Oof. Just roll.
There you go. Yes! Alright, go get it.
That's the only one I have to go through.
Let's hope.
Those flames will kill you in an instant. Just a flesh wound. You'll be okay. You'll live.
Those flames won't kill you in an instant. Come on, you survived much worse, Leon.
Much worse.
Although, apparently you do have one weakness. You can get your head chopped off from spinning blades. So maybe fire would take you down.
Unless, I don't know if you've ever seen it, unless you're Inuyasha, I mean, you may have a chance.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, nice. Oh, all right, I'm going to run through. All right, phew.
Oh, okay, there you go.
All right. Come on, Leon, kick the door.
Kith and kin.
I didn't bring any evidence, did you? Nope. Nope, but luckily some of these zombies have them wrapped around their necks. Oh. When did she give you a ring? Conveniently, just 2 minutes ago. Back when your sister. Ooh, too soon? Survive the zombie attack. All right, cool.
It's cool with the fire of a thousand suns.
Yeah.
I wouldn't stand too close to that.
Yeah. I thought I'd try my luck.
How strong is this flamethrower to where it's blowing that far down this ramp? Well, bridge.
It's, Well, I guess there's no air coming through here, so I'm surprised it just doesn't set us all on fire, actually. I don't know how it stays aimed.
There's a zombie crawling behind me.
That's all right. I got him.
Balazar. He is here.
Hey, what's up, Balazar? Welcome. Kitty and I are zombieing it up tonight. I like that we're playing this campaign too, because this does fit with Zombie Month, whereas most of the other ones don't. until they get to China.
My arms
There's
are
some
tired.
Zombies in China. I was going to say, I was like, how you doing over there? Balazar's been playing zombie games for Zombie Month too, as has Angel, which is pretty cool. She was playing Resident Evil 6 the other day, and Balazar, what was that game you were playing? It was weird looking. It was like this over the head Sims kind of, like, you know, SimCity kind of look to it, but you were sending in helicopters to save people, which was pretty awesome.
Speaking of Sims, I think.
Like, we're. Yeah?
Hmm? No, go ahead.
Go ahead.
I don't know if you guys ever knew, but, like, there's, like, the Sims add on called Sim Supernatural.
Oh, wow, no.
And they have zombies. They actually have zombies and werewolves and everything in that one.
Get out of here.
It's really cool.
That's cool. I gotta check that out. Helena. Zombie Night Terror was the first game I was playing, and Adam Zombie Smasher was the second. Both were pretty fun. Oh, nice. Yeah, I think it was Adam Zombie Smasher was the one I saw. This part sucks. Because that thing in the water.
I like the joke that Leon made when he said, I wish that I can fight in warm water for once.
Yeah.
They're not up here. Could this be it? I'm sorry, hold on. I'm looking for something for my dad.
That's okay. Take your time.
This one? Those ain't it either. Alright, give me 1 second, you guys.
Yay! Blue crest.
Another ball. No, they ain't it either. Play this while I look.
Hey, Seek, when is Gotham City Bricks kicking off? That's the name of your show, right? Yeah. Balazar, it's StarTube show. So, yes, starts on Monday, Balazar.
This can't be it, is it? Okay. Okay. Sorry about that.
No problem. I got a blue crest up here in case you haven't found this one.
Is it the one on dry land? Is that, yes, like the coffin thing? Yeah, I got that one.
Yeah. Okay. Cool, cool, cool. Gogeta said, I named my dog in Dragon Age Echo. Oh, dude, Gogeta, thank you. That's awesome. Echo, you are forever a video game dog now. What are you doing, Echo? What are you doing? Hang on 1 second.
Mm-hmm.
What? Stop barking at people. Stay, hey. Get back. Whoa, whoa. Otis.
Come on. Hey, hey. Why is this tunnel so long?
You're fine. Echo's friend, Otis, showed up to say hi to him. Sometimes he comes and knocks on our door.
I believe it.
Yep.
If we leave our pug Debo outside for too long, he'll knock on the door to let him know that he ready to come in.
Oh, gee. No, I'm not under attack. I'm going to be okay. He will be Echo Destroyer of Worlds. That's awesome.
Helena, are you okay?
Ooh,
no. Way over here now.
I'll cover you as much as I can. Just keep moving forward.
Be a big girl, Helena.
Boom. You need Oda's command for when he gets mentioned, or it's over, Seek. I will. He definitely likes his cameos. He's like, mention me now.
Okay, Leon, go. Leon, I can't get through. Can you open it from your?
Yeah. I'm working on it. All right. Here we go. Go, go, go.
Can you get through now?
Yeah, I'm good.
Yeah, I think I will. I'll make an Otis command. I'll probably spend some of tomorrow and stuff updating Moobot and updating my YouTube channel, and I want to finish editing a couple more Gotham City Bricks episode, so that way when I launch on Monday, I have enough for the whole rest of the week.
No, go towards the spikes, you stupid snake.
No way we're getting to that.
Oh, you're already on it.
Everything here is activated by cranks.
So we kill whoever's turning them.
I don't understand. What am I supposed to do here? Do I have to jump through those spikes?
No, you have to, like, it's like a zombie on the other side, like, turning a crank. You have to shoot it.
Oh, there is. Okay. I don't see him. Oh, on the other side. Gotcha. I thought that was you. I honestly thought that was you over there. I was like, oh, Alina's... She's... What is she doing?
Guess what? There's no crank here. I'm gonna look for
of course
it.
There's not. There's not a... There's no crank here.
True. Well, what the hell else are we gonna do?
A cranky crank.
You better be holding a crank, zombie. Because that would be convenient and exactly what I want from this game. Come on, come on.
Oh, while you do that, I'll be back.
All right, do your thing. I'm just going to let them come down and get me. I don't even care anymore. Hey, Ariel Draco, what is up, dude? Welcome back. Everyone else tuning in tonight, thank you for being here. We are continuing Zombie Month today with co-op Resident Evil 7, Resident Evil 6, I'm sorry. Resident Evil 6, the Leon and Helena campaign. And, you know, we played the Sherry and Jake campaign on Joe After Work's channel last week. Now we're playing this, and then I think next weekend we're going to play with Lil C. I'm going to try to contact him, see if he's available next weekend to play the Chris Redfield campaign with Pierce Nivens, his partner. I'm doing well, Draco. Thank you. I'm feeling a lot better. My head is feeling a lot better. My chest is feeling a lot better. Definitely recovering and doing my best to get back to my normal state so we can have some more zombie fun on here. Oh, she had to step away. She had to step away, so. Ow. But she'll be back in a second. All right, and whoa. Okay, I'm getting tired of this. I don't want that gun anymore. There we go.
I return.
You're back. Don't worry. I'm gonna grab this, and we're heading out. Don't roll, Leon. Don't you roll. Rolling scares the living crap out of me. Oh, it's a zombie. It's a zombie. He lived. No.
You can stand up now.
I'm gonna be careful and not. I would love to stand up, Kitty, but then there would be crap running down my leg.
We gotta lay off the Chipotle.
Oh, I don't need Chipotle when there's zombies and aliens involved. Go get assist with my game glitch, and now my character runs like he really has to poop. Well, he sounds like my kind of character.
Lucky I ain't got no bullets in this gun.
All right.
Try this again.
Duck, duck, dodge, roll, dip, dance.
Dodger there.
Yeah, I'm just over here having fun with Leon. Finally making it out of here. I love that they. Oh yeah, they won't let us do that because Leon has to be on the left and Helena has to be on the right. Trap door, you got.
Wait, what if a plot twist for all of the Resident Evil was the fact that it was just like a reality scare show?
I mean, it's an elaborate one. It's one that has like the budget of like a Michael Bay movie or something, because this is ridiculous. Like, that's my other thing about the game is the set pieces and locales. It's like, especially in 4, 5, and 6, they get so stupid. Like, look at this place. Nothing like this exists. This is the most ridiculous thing I've ever seen. This,
have you seen National Treasure?
Yeah, that's also fake. These things, like, the settings in this game make zombies seem realistic.
I promise you.
Oh man, I got 2 bullets left.
Are you really
gun.
Playing 2 casino-like games?
Who is? Oh, your dad?
Yeah.
There's a secret. Oh, Jesus. Okay, all right.
I figured you wanted to kill him.
Yeah, I did. No, I appreciate you leaving that for me. Because that was just good old-fashioned revenge there. So the second form of that heartthrob monster from the first level, its second form is in this level, and this is the form that's going to be actually in the next Resident Evil movie.
I've never seen the second form, unless I've seen it and just never paid attention to it.
Yeah, I don't think anyone even realizes that it's its second form. I didn't either until I read like the file page or whatever.
I never read the files. I don't know. Maybe I should start reading them.
I want to, because I was like, there's got to be a good story in this game. And there is. Unfortunately, though, it's just in the damn files.
Okay, Helena. Zombies don't like you when you talk back to them.
Points.
Ooh, can I shoot them from here? I can't.
Nice. Oops. Whoa, I got our backs. Boom. Kinda.
Ah, he's coming.
Oh, that one had dynamite strapped to his back. I wasn't ready for that.
No, wasn't ready.
Dude, don't you know it's time for you to die now? Where is that? Is it later on? There's a emblem around here somewhere. I'll find it. Once I'm in the spot, I'll go, oh, that's where it is.
I hope it's not on that part when, like, all the rocks and stuff are falling. You have to, like, hurry up and run through them.
We can shoot it early. That's why I'm looking for it.
Can't see my crew. There's a zombie behind me, and I knew it.
I think I gotta throw you here.
Oh, it's right over there.
You seen it?
I shot it.
Where is it?
Over in this corner.
Ah, there it is. Yep. There we go. Got it. Cool. No, Leon.
Oh, wait. Okay. I just want those points.
Yeah. Get those points. All right, now. Hey, nice work.
A lot of unnecessary acrobatics.
When isn't things unnecessary in this game?
Elena, you're a strong, independent woman.
You don't need no man, girl. I don't know if we just got raided or something, but we went from like 6 viewers to 12, 13. Like in an instant. Yeah, holy cow. Everyone who's watching, thanks for tuning in.
Yes, hello, we are everyone. Playing.
That is
Whoa,
Kitty.
I almost walked into that.
Oh, I am Seek, and we are playing Resident Evil 6 co-op for Zombie Month on my channel. And Kitty, thanks again for being here, by the way.
Always. If I have it, I love to play with people.
Nice. Chomley, why are you yelling Otis? That was like 10 minutes ago. Chomley, you're drunk off Diet Coke. What are you doing? Oh, shoot.
Don't shoot it, because it has a bomb.
Oh, okay. Well, I already shot it twice. Hopefully I didn't blow it up.
No, you didn't.
Okay, whew, good thing I'm a bad shot. Come at me, bro. Oh, he blew up. My chat lagged. Oh no, yes, sorry, that was... That's okay, it happens. You're the drunk one, Seek. I'm so drunk off Pepsi. It's ridiculous. She yelled, I'm the drunk one. This is actually not an elaborate bridge system. This is hashtag the most war. Inefficient anything. Hashtag war. Oh, yeah, she's the horseman war.
It's a zombie behind me. I hear him.
Got him. Luckily, I can shoot through bridges. Hey, Johnny, you like my new gun? It shoots through schools. It's like my favorite line from that movie. Too bad we're not Chris Redfield. I would just uppercut this boulder. Bam!
I wonder if he broke any of his fingers after all that.
Fingers? His... What are you talking about? His forearm should be destroyed.
He shattered fingers. His hands.
Yeah, his whole arm's gone. It's cut off now. He's got a robot arm for the new game.
Yeah, I knew one of us was going to fall.
Yeah, I was like, it's going to be me. It's going to be me.
It's all, you know, the funny thing is, I'm always the one that fall, even after he cross it.
Well, welcome to playing a game with Seek Donnelly.
I got donut sides.
Oh, I gotta rotate.
Rotation. Teamwork makes the dream work.
Teamwork does make the dream. Oh, oh no. Shit, oh. Well, that just happened. This looks really weird on my chat, where I have my hand right now. So I'm rotating this thing. Like, Seek, what kind of game are you playing? Playing the game where dreams come true.
Honey pop.
Oh. See, yeah, this is not an efficient bridging system. Everything's falling apart.
Well, they're probably pretty old. My question is, how did the people that even created this system got out? That's the real question here.
Yeah.
You think if we don't run this part of fall? I don't think this part of fall. I'd never stick around long enough just to find out.
Yeah, I'm too worried that it will.
Come on, Helena. Be a big girl. You do this. How does that knock you over?
I know. Well, it doesn't matter. It used it against the zombies, too. So when you push that one zombie, if you jumped over, it just knocked it over. Go get us. People joke about that, but at the point in the fight, Wesker has... Wait, hold on. go get us. People joke about that, but at the point in the fight, Wesker was chasing down my friend and I. His lifeline is getting out. It really felt like I was at that moment in panic. He really needed to move the rock and went so far to punch it in desperation. It still doesn't make it realistic. He definitely was desperate. He's like, I got to save Sheva. His arm should be just putty. All the bones in his arm should be completely gone. That's okay, buddy. He said I can't type when I'm tired. That's okay, dude. But I get what you mean.
This whole scene, they should have drowned.
Yeah. Man. Well, you know, I mean, they survived two car accidents already. I don't think water is going to hurt them. And then pretty soon we'll perform stroke. Yes, go. Stroke, Leon. Stroke. All right, I'm going to get some air. Oh, this battle's tough. This battle is tough.
It's another one.
Oh, come on. Swim, Leon. Swim. Ayo, Leon. John Lee said.
Swim like your life depends on it. As it does.
It so does. Come on, Leon. Go, go, go.
I don't even see you.
I'm right behind you now.
Okay.
Took me a minute to catch up, but I finally got here.
I'm going to get this air pocket up here.
I'm gonna follow you.
One here? Yeah. Thank you.
Yep. Air pocket. Oh, whoa. What's up, zombie head? At his push that got it in, he just punched because he was panicking in that moment to help Sheva. But yeah, he probably broke some fingers. I don't know. I think fingers is tame. I feel like I'm punching a boulder. I mean, then again, Chris is a much bigger guy than I am.
Seemed like he lost a lot of weight in set and six compared to five.
Compared to five, yeah. Seem like it, but I think he's just wearing bigger, more gear in six.
In five?
In five, I think he's big, but I think in six he has a lot of gear, so it makes him look smaller. That happens sometimes, actually. A lot of military guys that are big, they wear like these tight vests, and then they put like guns, you know, guns strapped everywhere, and kind of makes them feel a little, makes them look a little like smaller. But in the Vendetta, I don't know if you saw that Vendetta trailer for the CGI movie, but he's starting to look a little smaller, but I'm going to just guess it's because he's like almost 50 now. Or actually he's in his early I would say he's probably in his late 30s, early 40s, because in Resident Evil 1, he's like 21 or 23, something like that. And then in,
okay, I'm sorry. I didn't think I was going to make that.
Oh, that's right. And then I think Resident Evil 6 takes place like 18 years later or something like that. So he's got to be like in his late 30s, early 40s now. Kick its ass, kitty, kick it.
Might not make it. I just barely.
Oh, good. Barely works for me.
That's a lot of. Right. You can imagine how fast is this fish swimming?
Oh, well, it's fast enough to where.
Mutant thing.
Yeah, I mean, we should all be dead right now.
They can hold their breath for a long time.
Alright. Ooh. Oh!
An eyeball.
G Jeez, that's gruesome. Yeah, Balazar, this thing's nasty looking. Oh, you're hurry the hell up there? Okay. Oh, this is where.
Hold on, let me stay ahead of you.
All right.
It's easier for me to shoot that way.
Cool. All right, I'm slowing down. Tell me when you're ready.
You can come on, because you gotta go through the gate first.
All right, cool. I'm coming. All right, I'm through.
Give me a few seconds to get to the.
No problem.
Okay, go.
All right, going. Yeah, shit. Ooh, nice shooting.
Lena, we need some backup.
Yeah, Lena, you're awesome. You're a good shot. All right, nice.
1 second, let me jump down.
Oh, okay. Oh, zombie. Shit. Yep, it is coming. Oh, thank goodness you're so good at shooting. Damn. No, turn to Leon. Leon, that way. Don't swim out into the ocean. Oh my
god. Did you
god,
get the emblem
you.
That was over in the
Yeah,
what
I got I was going to say I got to run back. I'll be back in a second. Oh my goodness. Yeah.
You think they will have a cold by the end of all this?
A cold? Oh yeah. Well, no, because they're around fire as much as they're around water.
It's also true.
They're like, oh, I feel a cold coming on, and then they catch on fire in an airplane, and they're like, my cold's gone, my headache's gone, and now I just feel alive.
Ran past it.
Oh, is that? It's back there. Oh, yeah, okay. Boom. Thank you. Sometimes I do that. I'm like, you know what? I'll get you later, Emblem.
That's another thing I kind of hate about this game, is that there's only certain emblems you could get with certain characters.
Yes. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, when we were playing the Sherry and Jake campaign, there was, like, right in the first part, like, Jake throws Sherry up. Yeah, and I'm like... I'm like, Joe, can you hit this? He's like, I don't think I can. I'm like, dang it, man. Like, God, that sucks so bad. The game's like, nope, you got to play as both characters to get all the emblems. It's like, dude, I already have to play this game 4 times. Jesus.
Yeah, you're a little hot.
Nice.
Wait for it.
Oh, he's angry.
Is he? Is he angry? Ready or not, here I come.
You can't hide. Are you dead?
Oh, there he goes. Dynamite.
LOL, this glitch is hilarious, though. I'm having a conversation with my characters. Go get it, says. He looks like he needs to poop so bad right now. Really takes me out of the moment, but in a hilarious way. Make sure he's wearing his brown pants.
That's one part. My feet stay cold.
Congrats,
yeah, I like
Leon.
The bomb kind of surprised them.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, Leon, come on. You've this is not the first city you've seen nuked all to hell.
Raccoon City.
Yep.
You know, if there was a zombie outbreak and I was to have my own town, I would be that person to name it Raccoon City.
Nice. Well, that's like someone always told me, like, Zeke, if you ever won the lottery, what would you do with the money? I said, I would build the Spencer Mansion from Resident Evil 1 and live in it.
You know, the whole mansion, I don't know, that's a little too creepy for me.
No, yep, it's just creepy enough for me. And I would have dinner parties once a year, and only one person would survive. Oh,
I want their phone.
I know, their phones are awesome.
Are they like anti-shatterproof and waterproof?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, Leon was just swimming with this thing for 10 hours.
Their little flashlight head pieces are pretty cool, too.
I agree.
Listen, Hunnigan, I need you to fake our deaths. Can you do that?
What? Can you do that, Hunnigan?
You know, I don't get the whole point of faking their deaths.
Because literally, well, the reason is because Simmons is like keeping tabs on them. But the worst part is Leon says it may not buy us a ton of time, but hopefully it'll give us a head start so we can make it through, you know, checkpoints and get on the airplane. So you're like, okay, so he knows he's up against someone who can track him. So faking his death might buy them a couple hours. But really, by the time they get on the airplane, Simmons knows they're alive. So it turns out to be really pointless.
This open window can lead somewhere or nowhere. It's up to you. What do you mean, who is this? It's Chris. Why won't you believe me?